So the topic of today's discussion is how to interface keypads with LPC2148 microcontroller. Keypads are available in multiple formats. 4x3 means 4 rows and 3 columns. 4x4 means 4 rows and 4 columns. What we are using today is a 4x3 matrix keypad. The main objective behind using a matrix keypad is that the keys are arranged in matrix format in rows and columns. Thereby, they reduce the number of pins that are necessary from the host microcontroller. For example, in this case, you are having totally 12 keys, 1, 2, 3, up to 12 keys. So if you are using one pin for each switch in this keypad, probably will end up in using 12 pins of your microcontroller. Whereas if you arrange the same in rows and columns format, in a matrix format, you would end up in using only 4 rows and 3 columns, totally 7 pins. So thereby, you save nearly 5 pins here. You need 1 pin for 1 row and 1 pin for 1 column. So totally 4 plus 3, we need only 7 pins here. Similarly, for a 4x4 matrix, there you have 16 keys, which means if you are connecting them individually, you would end up in having 16 pins. But since you are having in matrix format, you need 4 pins for rows and 4 pins for column. So with 8 pins, you will be comfortably able to receive data from all 16 pins. And in that case, you save nearly 8 pins. So the rationale behind using matrix keypad is just to save pins. And more importantly, these keypads are very vital numerical input devices in most products where the user have to enter data directly to the system, just like a ticketing machine, just like your point of sale machines where the user needed to enter data, or some kind of a security systems where the user needed to key in the password. So in a lot of these systems, the user has to enter the numerical information directly to the system. In such cases, we would have to use these keypads invariably. So the topic of today's discussion is how to interface such a keypad with our LPC2148. So this is the anatomy of this keypad. So this keypad essentially has totally 12 keys, totally 4 rows. So this is my row 1, row 2, row 3, and row 4. And we have 3 columns. And this is my column 1, C1, C2. So we need one pin from the microcontroller to connect these 4 rows and 3 columns. So we need totally 7 pins in this. Okay. Now, the rationale behind connecting this in matrix format is that in each of these rows, there is a key that is short-circuiting this column with the row. Which means, if you take this button 1, so what I'm talking here is this fellow. So this is the numerical key 1. So when I press this button short circuit this column versus this row, which means if I put a 0 here in this row, this 0 will be available here, here, as well as here. In all the 3 places, this 0 will be available. Whenever this key is pressed, the same 0 is communicated to this column. So this 0 is communicated. Similarly, when this key is pressed, the same 0 is communicated to this column. When this key is pressed, the same 0 is communicated to this column. So whatever the logic that you put in this particular row, this row pin, the same information is communicated to this column pin whenever such a key is pressed. And similarly, when you put a logic here in row 2, the same logic is available here, here, and here. In all the 3 places, that same information is available. When such a key is pressed, this logic is communicated to the same column 1, column 2, and column 3 as well. So this is what we do by means of keypad scanning. What do you mean by keypad scanning? We put a known logic in, say for example, I take this row 1, I put a 0 or a 1, depending upon your choice. So I put one known logic here, 0 I put here, and then check the values of C1 and C2 and C3, which of these inputs has the same logic as that of row 1. Suppose if C1 has a same logic means 0. If C1 has a value of 0, then I can determine then this particular key is pressed. Suppose if C2 is equal to 0, this fellow is pressed. If C3 is equal to 0, then in that case, this fellow is. When one fellow is having a logic of 0, the other 3 rows should have a different logic. Only then this logic will. Which means when I supply a 0 here, this has to be a 1, this has to be a 1, and this has to be a 1. So that we know exactly there can be no other keys in this particular column other than 1. Because we have supplied 0 in this row, all the other rows are 1. Let us try and understand this practically so that you have a better understanding. But as of now, you understand that the rationale behind arranging these rows and columns is to save the pins, and by keypad scanning algorithm. So it's called keypad scanning algorithm. Keypad scanning algorithm. We can determine through software which pin is pressed. Let us take a keypad. This is the keypad that I'm interested in, 4+3 keypad. So it has 4 rows and 3 columns. So before we try to understand that, let us construct a simple switch circuit and then try and see how it works. You must be aware of that already. Still, +3.3 volt is my power supply here. I take a resistor, a 10K resistor, and I connect one end of the resistor here. And I take a button and I connect one end of the button to this point. The other end of the button, I connect it to ground. So that is a simple and straightforward switch circuit, which I use. In order to measure the voltage, I take a DC voltmeter. One end of the DC voltmeter, I connect to the point of intersection of the resistor and the switch. The other end, I connect it to ground. Okay, so that's a simple, straightforward circuit. Now, how the circuit works, you know. When the switch is not pressed, the output available at this point is pulled up to 3.3 volt. Whenever I press this button, it takes 0 volt. So the value of the voltage available at that point depends upon the condition of the switch. So whenever I press the switch, it takes 0 volt. Whenever I release the switch, it takes 3.3 volt. Now, if I connect this particular point to any one of the pin of the microcontroller, it will read that pin and then it will happily take the decision. Problem with that is if you are going to assign one button to each of these keys, you would end up in having 12 keys here. So you need 12 buttons or 12 switches, and eventually you need 12 pins of the microcontroller, which I don't want. That is why this matrix keypad comes here. So by arranging this switch in matrix format, you end up in having 4 rows and 3 columns. So it is enough. We spend only 7 pins of the microcontroller. So now let us see how are we going to use the same switch circuit with the keypad. Now I just block copy this fellow and put it here, and I take this keypad and use it instead of, maybe I'll just shift these two fellows here. So this is our old keypad circuit. So I just eliminate this fellow now. Okay, so if I eliminate, that key is eliminated because this is a simple switch. Here also we have switches, isn't it? So what I do, okay. So in the place of the old switch, which was there, maybe I would put it here for your understanding. Okay. So in the place of old switch, I'm using any one of the switch of this 12. So what I do, I take this first fellow and connect it to ground. Okay. And I take the output of this fellow and connect it to here. So what I have done, I have eliminated the switch in our old circuit. In the place of that switch, I have connected a keypad. And I have used numerical one switch as a replacement for the old switch. Still, it will behave the same way. Okay, so if you want to see, initially the switch is not pressed. So if I press this button, you can see that it is going 0. See this fellow? So if I press this button number 1, it is going 0. But it is not showing the same result for different other keys, because we have not used our keys. We have used only the topmost key, 1, 1. So when I press that button, it is going 0. When I release that button, it is going 0. Are you able to see this fellow? So when I press it, press the numeric button 1, it is going 0. When I release, it is not. Right. Now, to make the circuit just clean, what I do? So I just remove this lengthy cable here. I put the ground close to this and I connect it directly here. So this circuit and this circuit are one and the same. Only difference is in the place of this switch, I have connected the key. Now, I connect 4 such grounds here for all the 4 rows here, and I read the same output. If you read the output now, if I press 1, it is going 0. If I am pressing 4, again it is going 0. If I am pressing 7, it is going 0. If I am pressing star, again it is 0. Maybe put the voltmeter close to this switch for your understanding. And if I zoom it and run this, if I press 1, it is going 0. If I press 4, it is going 0. If I press 7, it is going 0. If I press star, again it is going. Okay. Now, since all the 4 keys connected to this column 0 are going to 0 whenever I press, I don't know which key of the 4 is actually pressed. See, all the 4 are giving 0. So if we have to find an algorithm in order to know which of these 4 keys is actually pressed. So which means what? if I'm going to connect all the four pins to ground, and if you read this value, there is no way you can figure out which of these four keys. So the only way in which you can figure out which of these four keys pressed is by what, I connect one of these, I connect all the four to microcontroller pins. I make only one fellow of that four as a zero, rest of the fellows as ones. And then I see what is the value of column one. If column one is a zero, then one first fellow is, suppose if it is not a one, then I make this as a one and make the second row alone as a zero. Rest of the pins are all ones. And again, I read the value of column one. I check whether if it is equal to zero. If it is equal to zero, then the fourth. Again, if it is not equal to four, then I go to the third row. I make this fellow as a one. Sorry, this fellow as a zero. And rest all pins as one. And see whether this particular key is. So what I'm doing, since only one column is present for four rows, and in order to examine which exact key is pressed of the four row, we have to cyclically make only one row as zero, all others have ones, and we have to examine the value of column one. For which value of row, if C1 gives a value of zero, then that particular key is. The same logic we use for C2 as well as for C3, it is the rational behavior. So the very first thing what I do is I will delete this circuit. I no longer need this. I delete these fellows. Okay. So instead of seeing this with a voltmeter and visually seeing it, I read this with the microcontroller pin. So I use port 1 for this. Okay. Maybe I can duplicate it three times. So this is my column 2 and this is my column 3. So in order to read the column value, I connect the second pin to port 1.17 and column 3 with 1.18. Okay. So column 1 is going to 1.16, 1.17 and 1.18. These three pins are connected to columns. Rows, you can use any pins. Say, for example, 21st pin I connected to row 1, 22nd pin I connected to row 2, 23rd pin I connected to row 3, and 24th pin I connected to row 4. So this is all it is. So what is the logic? First, let us make 0 to row 0 alone and read the three columns and check which of the keys giving a 0. If column 1 is a 0, then first fellow is pressed. If column 2 is a 0, this key is. If column 3 is 0, this key is. If none other thing is pressed, then you make the second row alone as a 0 and read C1, C2, C3 again. If C1 is 0, fourth key is pressed. C2 is 0, fifth key is pressed. C3 is 0, sixth key is. Like that, we do it in a cyclic fashion. This is called keypad scanning algorithm. So let us go back to our coding window and create a new file and save this with keypad.h. Okay. So this keypad.h will have that keypad scanning algorithm. So as usual, we put the pre-processor directives as define column 1. Where are we connecting column 1? 16th pin of port 1. So it is 116. Column 2, we are using 17th pin of port 1. Column 3, we are using 18th pin of port 1. And in order to use the rows, we are going to use all the four together, not individual pins. So we use one full port. So 16 to 23 is one full port. That is port 1.2. So as define keypad port or key port. Key port is 1.2. Port 1 block 2 it is. Port 1 block 2. Okay. So I have only one function here. Keypad scan function or get keypad. Something of the sort. This get keypad function returns which key the user has pressed. So unsigned character. This fellow returns a value. What is the value it returns? Which key the user has pressed? It doesn't take any parameter. So this is the only function probably I need here. So let us try and build this function. So this function should return a value to the user. Okay. So I put a while loop, while some condition. And the while loop should terminate only when the user has pressed the key. Otherwise, it should not return the value. So once the condition fails, it has to return some key value to the user, return the key. So define what is key here. Unsigned character key, assign the key value to some hexadecimal value, say character X. So I have defined a key variable and I have assigned that to X. So in the conditional statement, I put while, as long as key is equal to X, I do this while loop. And in the while loop, if the user has pressed any one of the key of the button, the value of the key would change. In that case, it will come out of the while loop and it will return the key. If no key is pressed, then it will remain in the void. So the idea is the getKeyPad function should return a value to the user depending upon which key the user has. If the user has not pressed any key, it will still remain in the same while one loop. That is the idea. So let us scan the keypad first. So what is the logic here? First, we have to make this fellow alone, port 1.21 alone. So port write, which port I'm trying to write? This keyport. Keyport is 1.2. What is the value that I want to write? 21st pin, isn't it? So how we connected? 21st pin is going to A, that is row 1. 22nd is going to row 2. 23 is going to row 3. 24, it is 0 to 23 actually. 24 corresponds to the next pin. So let us delete this. So 23 is the last pin in that particular block. Or you can use a different block instead of using the same block, but still. So 19th goes to block 0, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. It's not 19, 20. Yeah. So the topmost four pins of block 2, that is 1.23, 22, 21, and 20 goes to this. So this is my 8-bit notepad. So port 1.16 to 23. 16 is connected to C1, 17 is connected to C2, this is C3, 18 is connected to C3, 19 is not connected, 20 is row 1, 21 is row 2, 23 is row 3, 20, 21, 22, 23 is row 1, row 2, row 3. So this is how it is. So here let us not worry about this fellow, so I am making all of this as ones. Row 1 alone, I am making 0 first, and then rest of the pins are making high. So this is the first condition. Second condition, I am not bothered about these fellows. Row 1, I make a 1. Row 2 alone, I make a ground. This is 0. This is a 1. This is a 1. In the third condition, I make row 3 alone a 0. And this is a 1. Fourth condition, 1, 1, 1. And this, these are the possible values that we needed to send. So what is the hexadecimal value of this? Equal to hexadecimal. This is the most significant bit, isn't it? So this is 12. So I have written in the reverse order. Like this is my LSB, this is my MSB. So the value is 11 12 12 plus 2 14. So it is 0E. So it is FE. So this is equal. It is EF, not FE. EF. This is equal to 8 plus 2 12 plus 1 13. 0XDF. Third value is hexadecimal. 8 plus 2 10 plus 1 11. So it is BF. Fourth value is, it is 0111. So it is hexadecimal 7F. So these are the four values that we should be worried about. Okay, so I'll just copy this and put it for your understanding. Okay, so this is my LSB, this is my MSB, and this is my LSB. That also you should understand, right? So first value, we start with EF. So when I send EF, this fellow alone will become 0. All other fellows, this fellow alone becomes 0. All other fellows are 1. So you send the first row alone 0. Read column 1, 2. So once you send that, my data equal to digital read. Which pin I have to read? Column 1, C1. First column I read. This column I read. If that column is a 0, what is the meaning? If my data is equal to a 0, means column 1, if it is a 0, what does it mean? It means the user has pressed a button. So the key value, you have to assign this fellow. Key value is equal to the user has pressed the first key. Number one key, yes. This key, yes. And then break. The moment a condition is reached, you break the while loop. We no longer need it. Close this. And the same thing I do for the other fellow. Read the value of C2. If my data is equal to 0, the key value is 2 in this case. Again, read the value of C3. In this case, it is 3. So that completes my first condition for port write equal to EF. Same thing we repeat it for the other four rows. What is the next condition? DF. When I write DF, this fellow alone becomes a 0, all the other pins become 0. So the place of EF, it is DF. Again, you read C1, C2, C3. In this case, it is 4, 5, 6. This case, 4, 5, 6. For the next row, it is 7, 8, 9. In this case, it is BF, 7, 8, 9. And the last condition is 7. 7F corresponds to the last row. So what are the three keys in the last row? Star, zero, hash. It is a star, zero, and hash. This hash key. Yes. So it will come out of this while loop only when the key has a value other than X. So in that case, you return that. So this is the keypad scanning logic, which we would main.c. So I just remove this function, make key equal to get key. What is the function we wrote? Get keypad. Get keypad and simply display this in the LCD display. If my key is not equal to X, there is no way that it will return an X because it will return a value only when it is other than X, but still we double check it. If my key is not equal to X LCD data, you pass a small amount of delay here. This delay is necessary because otherwise it will duplicate the same key thrust multiple number of times. So we have to give appropriate delay so that a single key is giving only one. My key is not defined, so unsigned character. Keypad is not used, so hash include keypad.h. Let us see this output first. One. So for every press, it is giving multiple outputs, which means our delay period is a bit low. So we have to go to our main.c. We have removed that 2 here because of latency in our LCD. Once you have timer, you can use appropriate delays here. So the time needed for one key press is typically 40 to 50 milliseconds. So if your delay is less than that, it will trigger multiple key press. So you have to make sure that the time delay is large enough to accommodate that delay. 1, 4, 7, star, 2, 5, 8, 0, 3, 6, 9, then hash. Okay, so that concludes all the keys of that particular keypad. Maybe we can use this information for any authentication like keypad scanning and security system, designing point of sale machineries where you get numerical inputs from the user, password validation, all those. But then the way in which keypad works is eventually like this.